Graduate from Hope's Ready for Life program this spring, and then he plans to return to Chelsea to work at Inverness Country Club. Coach Mitchell says Parker has served as a dedicated member of our program and has been an absolute joy to be around. His passion for our players and for Hope's basketball has been remarkable. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Parker Doan. Next, student assistant Travis Voss from Zeeland East High School. Travis is escorted by his parents, John and Lisa Voss. Travis is an education major who carries a 3.76 GPA. After graduation, Travis plans to work for the Z-Kids summer camp and will seek a social studies teaching position this fall. Coach Mitchell says Travis has been incredibly dedicated to the men's basketball team and has the basketball knowledge and passion to become an outstanding coach. His commitment to the players and coaching staff has been incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Travis Voss. Next is student assistant Luke Putnam, a native of Rochester, New York. Luke is joined by his parents, David and Susan Putnam. Luke will graduate with an engineering degree and a 3.7 GPA. Following graduation, Luke will head home to New York to work at Oak Hill Country Club as an operations intern, where he will help host the 2023 PGA Championship this May. In the fall, Luke will then pursue a career as an engineer. Coach Mitchell says Luke was a member of our program as a player, but following an injury, he transitioned into the student assistant role. His loyalty and contribution to the program has been tremendously impactful, which is shown in the genuine respect he has from our players and coaches. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Luke Putnam. Testing. Next, number 11, Brady Swinehart. Brady Swinehart is a native of Ionia and is joined by his parents, Scott and Ann Swinehart. Brady holds a 3.7 GPA and will graduate with a degree in accounting. The 2022 MIAA champion plans to study for the CPA and then seek a job in public accounting. In addition, Brady would like to explore the potential opportunity of coaching basketball. Coach Mitchell says Brady has been an instrumental contributor to the success of the men's basketball culture. Elected as a captain prior to this season, Brady embraced that role and poured himself into his teammates and coaches every day. He has lived the role of what an unselfish team leader needs to be and has set the standard for all future Hope basketball captains. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Brady Swinehart. Next is number 32, Harris Hawkins. Harris Hawkins is from Lexington, Kentucky, and is being escorted by his parents, Mark and Heidi Hawkins, and his brother, Mason. Harris is a 3.7 GPA student and a 2022 MIAA champion. He will graduate with a business degree this spring. Upon graduation, Harris plans to spend the summer umpiring baseball games and will seek a job in sales in the fall. Coach Mitchell says Harris's dedication and grit has been incredibly inspirational during his career at Hope College. He has come back twice from season-ending injuries to reclaim his role on the team as one of the hardest workers and one of the most dedicated teammates to ever wear the orange and blue. His positive attitude and team-first approach has been profound and inspirational. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Harris Hawkins. And finally, number 24, Evan Thomas. Evan Thomas is from Okemos High School and is joined by his parents, Jennifer Everhart and Joseph Thomas. With a 3.9 GPA, Evan will graduate as a biology major this spring. Evan is a two-time captain and led the Dutchman to the 2022 MIAA regular season and tournament championships and was named the league MVP and NABC first team All-American. As a junior, Evan Thomas scored the 9th most points in single season history and is currently the 20th all-time leading scorer for Hope College. Evan will be entering medical school at the University of Michigan in the fall. Coach Mitchell says ET is one of the most dynamic athletes to ever wear a Hope uniform. He achieved that status while excelling on the demanding pre-med track, which is an incredible achievement. The versatility and competitiveness that he plays with at both ends of the court has been special to witness, and he has helped and has helped him become one of the all-time greats to play at Hope College. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Evan Thomas. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for your seniors.
Hope because of the ability to play softball, but also the small class sizes was appealing. Also, when I came to my visit, the community is just open with arms, ready to invite you in. The coaches here were great.
Hope's always been this incredible place that we've just always...
As well. Number 0, Clayton Dykehouse, and number 3, TJ McKenzie. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for all our seniors, Parker Doan, Travis Voss, Luke Putnam, Brady Swinehart, Harris Hawkins, Evan Thomas, TJ McKenzie, and Clayton Dykehouse.
Whether you're building your dream home, buying a fixer-upper, or downsizing, the process can feel overwhelming. Let the local team at Lighthouse Title help the closing process be one less worry. Just ask your real estate professional or lender to close at Lighthouse Title. To learn more about how we're involved in our 35 communities or to ask us any questions about the process, visit us online at lighthousetitle.net.
Rasper. at an important moment in American history. There's some big questions on the table, such as how do we indeed become a land of opportunity for all rather than a land of privilege for a few? And the answer to that question is being decided, not just in the political arena and not just through cultural conversations. The answer to that question is being decided, perhaps most importantly of all, through the admissions and financial aid processes on college campuses across the country. Because higher education has the potential to indeed make us a land of opportunity for all. Higher education can be the great equalizer. We spend a lot of time talking about income inequality, but at the end of the day, income is the outcome. What we ought to be talking about is education inequality. Higher education can be the great equalizer. Research shows this. There's an economist at Harvard named Raj Chetty, and his research shows that a student who comes from a low-income background and a student who comes from a high-income background, if they attend the same college or university, they have nearly identical opportunities for success after they graduate. But the problem, of course, is that those students don't attend the same colleges and universities. And another economist, Carolyn Hoxby at Stanford, shows that one of the main reasons that students who would be eligible to attend great universities and often would be eligible for financial aid, one of the main reasons they don't attend is the price, the sticker price. The sticker price scares people off. And what we're seeing now, because there's new data out, new data shows that many high schoolers are eliminating colleges from consideration because of the price, because of the posted price. In fact, data out this year shows that 73% of high schoolers eliminated college from consideration because of the posted price. And that number, 73%, is up from 68% last year and up from 56% 2 years ago. Access to higher education is a problem. But what we see at Hope College is that there's another problem, which is access to a life of impact after students graduate. Because the students who do find their way into higher education oftentimes, too oftentimes, are burdened by debt. And that debt skews the kind of things that students are doing after they graduate. Too often, students, because they have so much debt, are chasing income rather than pursuing a life of impact. And they're chasing income because they have to pay off their debt. Hope Forward is a vision that we have at Hope College that will eliminate these problems of access.
Good afternoon, and welcome to DeVos Fieldhouse. As you see on your screen, a blustery but sunny February afternoon here in Holland, Michigan. DeVos Fieldhouse, the site of this MIAA contest, final regular season game in the MIAA season. The Hope Flying Dutchman taking on the Hornets of Kalamazoo College. Alongside Matt Margarone, I'm Jordan George. We're excited to bring this one to you from what is a pretty festive and full DeVos Fieldhouse on this Saturday afternoon.
Yeah, really energetic environment on this beautiful day in Holland, Michigan for an MIAA doubleheader coming off of a Hope big win for the women's team on senior day. We're carrying that energy into senior day again for another five seniors from Hope College.
Yeah, it's senior day here on the men's side, and we just had a great pregame ceremony honoring these seniors. We'll talk about them throughout the broadcast, and just a lot of people that have contributed not only to the basketball team at Hope, but to the college in general, and we'll have some storylines to follow with that one. And oftentimes the saying is on senior day, if the rest of your players can play as hard as your seniors do on senior day, then you have a good chance to win. So that'll be a goal for Hope here moving forward.
Yeah, we saw that play out in the women's game. Actually, a freshman was the leading scorer, Carson Carlin, in the women's game. And we'll see kind of who shows up to play. It's always a special environment here in this gym to play in front of this great crowd. And so a lot of times on senior day, seniors come out and play with a level of energy and nostalgia and just that special feeling. So it's going to be a great day here.
Yeah, just kind of setting the scene for this matchup and where we are in the season. This is the final regular season MIAA game. Hope is guaranteed to have the 3 seed for the MIAA tournament. That tournament will start on Wednesday, and Hope will host a first round game against whoever the 6 seed ends up being. It could be a couple different teams depending on results today. Adrian in that mix, Albion in that mix, a couple other teams. So Hope will host the game on Wednesday in the first round of the MIAA tournament. They're looking to build off a really successful rivalry win at Calvin in front of 4,000 people in Van Noort Arena and what was undoubtedly one of the highlights of the season for Hope. Hope has won 8 of their last 10, a team that sputtered a little bit to start, but they're trying to gain momentum and play their best basketball in March.
Yeah, you can't take away the fact that Hope is the reigning MIAA champion. They have the reigning MIAA Player of the Year, and they just haven't all been healthy at the same time this year. And so watch out. If you get a Hope healthy team going into the postseason, you never know what could happen. But the MIAA is a tough place to play. Last time these two teams played, it was a 10-point game. And so every game is a pick'em at this point, and you just got to come out ready to go, because any team can knock off any team in this league.
Yeah, this is the Kalamazoo team. It's going to be a tall task for them to come into a packed DeVos Fieldhouse. But they're a team that's been up to it. They lost by 10 to Hope on January 25. A team that's had some wins here in the last couple weeks as well. They come in 5-19 and 3-10 in the MIAA, but they have some really skilled individual players that we'll continue to talk about. We'll take a quick break. It's Senior Day here at DeVos Fieldhouse. Hope against Kalamazoo. We're going to have the national anthem and starting lineups and be right back after that. In the name, feel like you're in the game. Drop the top.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask you to please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America with the singing of our national anthem, please welcome Hope College freshman, Miss Genesis Clark.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Genesis Clark. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the DeVos Fieldhouse here on the campus of Hope College for today's MIAA contest between the Hornets of Kalamazoo College and your Hope College Flying Dutchman. Here this afternoon, starting lineups. First for the Hornets at 1-4, a 6'3 sophomore from Miami, Florida, number 22, DJ Courtney. And at 1-4 for the Flying Dutchman, a 6'1 senior from Ionia, number 11, Brady Swinehart. At 1-4 for the Hornets, a 6'4 sophomore from Cuyahoga Falls, Ohio, number 33, Josh Decker. And at 1-4 for the Flying Dutchman, a 6'3 senior from Lexington, Kentucky, number 32, Harris Hawkins. Starting at center for the Hornets, a 6'7 sophomore from Boise, Idaho, number 20, Lucas Broadsword. And at center for the Flying Dutchman, a 6'3 senior from Muskegon, number 3, TJ McKenzie. Starting at one guard for the Hornets, a 6'2 junior from Manchester, number 3, Ty Horkey. And at one guard for the Flying Dutchman, a 5'11 senior from Zealand, number 0, Clayton Dykhouse. And at the final guard spot for the Hornets, a 6'2 junior from Howell, number 24, Bobby Samples. And at the final guard spot for the Flying Dutchman, a 6'4 senior from Okemos, number 24, Evan Thomas. Kalamazoo College is coached by Nick Chiard. Hope College is coached by Greg Mitchell. Your officials this afternoon, Danny Sapp, Mike Hillary, and Doug Diekman.
And with that, we're just about ready to go here from DeVos Fieldhouse. Ton of energy in the building today. The fans are fired up. The players are fired up. It's senior day. All 5 seniors starting for Hope. A new-look starting lineup, but an appropriate one for this occasion.
Yeah, it's a pretty fun group of 5 for the Hope College Flying Dutchman against a young Kalamazoo squad. But Brady Swinehart and Harris Hawkins are getting some maybe first starts of the year, which is pretty fun for them on this senior day.
Yeah, it's great to see Harris Hawkins out there, a guy that's battled through so much in his time at Hope. We'll talk about it. Brady Swinehart out there, a guy who might provide some very needed 3-point shooting for this right. Hope team early in this one. Thomas jumps it up, and that's Bobby Samples, the junior from Howell. He'll trigger the offense for the Hornets. Inside game, really good ball movement for the Hornets. Josh Decker working against Thomas inside. Over to Broadsword, and Broadsword unable to finish. Thomas, as he does so well, gets the rebound.
Great little first defensive possession for the Hope, limiting to 1 shot, and they bring it back down, look to run the offense.
Here's Dykhouse out front with it. Shot clock clicks down to 10. McKenzie aggressive out front. Unable to hit off the back iron is TJ McKenzie, and here comes Kalamazoo.
Yeah, Hope College is starting 5 seniors. Don't really have a true post presence with this group, so looking to run the offense around the perimeter and just got a 1-3.
Deep triple try by Samples there, in and out. Here comes Thomas. Yeah, a little bit of an awkward construction here, as can sometimes happen on senior night. Offensively without a post presence. Thomas playing inside here to start this one. Swinehart out to Dykhouse. Hope unable to get a solid look here in the first couple trips offensively. It's going to be important for the Flying Dutchman.
It's great to see Evan Thomas back out there coming off an injury. Early 3 from Brady Swinehart. Great way to start on senior day. As you said, much needed shooting.
Swinehart, the sharpshooter from Ionia, knocks it in on senior day. That's a huge basket for the Flying Dutchman, and a big one for Swinehart.
Oh, he's got to love that coming in a game like this, hitting the first 3 in his last game of the regular season here. And you can see the smile on his face as he runs down the court.
A little bit of momentum here for Hope as they get a good defensive stop there as well. And Hope trying to build on that right now against this Hornets team that's looking to try to come into DeVos Fieldhouse and steal one against the Flying Dutchman. McKenzie aggressive out to Swinehart. Swinehart triggered it up again. No good, but it's a good look for Hope.
Swinehart is a great shooter, one of our pure shooters on the team, and so as he's in this game, they're going to keep looking for him.
Samples inside. Oh, nice roll and pass. Thought Hope might have gotten away with a foul there as well. That's Broadsword finishing for 2.
Yeah, Kalamazoo early on has looked to go inside against Hope's smaller team. Really got the advantage right now.
McKenzie is a guy that'll fire it from the long line. That one is off. Here comes Kalamazoo. DJ Courtney with the ball working against Hawkins. Nice job by Courtney reaching and finishing.
Yeah, Harris Hawkins with an initial really good defense, but just a little up and under with the right-handed layup, which was with the offhand.
Here's Swinehart over to Hawkins. Hawkins is going to try a triple. That one's no good. Hope settling for shots from outside early, and that's been a big struggle this year for the Flying Dutchman, is shooting from the outside.
Yeah, I wouldn't say that's Hope's strength in the offensive end, and so they're going to want to look at to get inside, have Evan and Clayton really penetrate, and then get some better looks.
Horky dumps it off. That's Broadsword. Finds himself inside. They're going to say that's 3 seconds, as Good Hope swarming defense there from the Flying Dutchman.
Could have been 3 seconds. Could have been a little bit of an extra step there. Glad the ref called something at that point. Hope with some early good defense in this game, causing some turnovers and one and dones, but they just got to make some shots on the offensive side of the court.
Sometimes basketball's a funny game. It really just does come down to making or missing shots. And Hope, I think when they've had their best starts is when they can get a little bit of offensive momentum early in the ball game. McKenzie driving down the lane. That one was lost. Able to collect it, though, as McKenzie, and reset the offense for Hope. 10 on the shot clock. Nice find by Dykhouse to Hawkins inside. Hawkins goes up, and they'll say that's a jump ball. It's going to stay Hope ball.
Yeah, Hope's going to come in with some subs, get Gabe Quillen in the game, and Eli Schoonveld in for Harris and TJ. And Gabe's been great in the post all year, and I think that's going to kind of slow down our offense a little bit.
Quillen has had really the definition of a breakout season here in his sophomore year. Schoonveld falling away. That one is all air. Here comes Kalamazoo.
Yeah, almost a shot clock violation. That could have gone either way, but they're letting Kalamazoo run with it.
See who that one is tagged on, if it's Swinehart or Quillen. That'll be Swinehart. They'll say Swinehart got him earlier before Quillen elevated to try to block the shot.
Yeah, Broadsword is a really good player, really putting the pressure in on Hope's interior defense.
Lucas Broadsword, 6'7", sophomore out of Boise, Idaho. Interesting roster here for Kalamazoo. They have a player from Greece, a player from Florida and Idaho, another player from Florida, California. So quite an interesting roster construction. Good job of recruiting by Nick Giard.
Yeah. Kalamazoo's a young team, too. So look for them in years to come in the MIAA.
Quillen got that one poked away. Good defense here early from Kalamazoo, holding Hope to 3 points in the first 4 minutes.
Yeah, Hope again off to that slow start. They're going to want to get something going on the offensive end, really get it down into the paint and penetrate.
DJ Courtney making things happen, and you just get the sense here in the first 4 minutes that Kalamazoo is out hustling Hope just a little bit. Those 50-50 balls, rebounding, everything else, Kalamazoo's came to play.
Yeah, and if you spend any time watching this Hope men's team throughout the year, their energy really drives off getting stops and when that ball goes in the bucket. And so they're going to want to get some easy shots and watch that ball go through and their energy arrays. Sometimes it's a mental game, too, when one, two fall and don't fall in a row. Then you kind of get down on yourselves. And so we're going to want to watch Hope try and get one to just drop for him.
Samples triggering the inbound to Horky. Horky guarded by Schoonveld. Nice back cut, but here comes Hope. Good job by Dykhouse to collect it. He's going all the way over to Schoonveld. Eli Schoonveld all air on that triple. Extra pass by Swinehart.
Hope continues with the slow shooting from the outside.
This is a nice matchup to watch. J.J. Stevens and Quillen. Good ball movement. There's Samples. Right wing triple is all air as well. So both teams a little cold here early shooting the ball.
That's right. Hope has really got to get the ball inside. They're going to look to set some screens, get it down to...
And how about that? The big man, not a guard, the big man getting him out of their shooting slump. Gabe Quillen knocks it in from up top.
Well, they get it to the big, but they get him open, and Kalamazoo kind of gave him the space, and that's going to be good for Hope to expand the defense of Kalamazoo. If Gabe can hit those shots, that gets more space inside for him.
Quillen's shown the ability to do that. Shoots 41% from the three on the year, so big man can step outside and make it happen. Here comes Thomas. Hope leads by one here early.
It's great to see Evan Thomas back out on the court. He really puts pressure on the defense.
Swinehart, triple try. Yes, the senior. Swinehart, his second three ball of the game. He gives up the 4-point lead.
That's right. He's shooting 2 for 3 so far in this first quarter. That's our first half, and that's great for the senior.
On senior day, a guy who really, he's made a ton of shots in practice. If you talk to this Hope coaching staff, he's making it happen on the floor here in a big MIAA contest.
And he's calling for it again on the wing, and Evan Thomas says, hey, I'm dribbling it in.
Turnover Hope. Here comes Horky. Pass down to DJ Courtney, and it's lost. Hope's going to go on the run. Track meet here over the last couple of minutes. Dykhouse was looking for Swinehart once again.
Great defensive play by Swinehart, knocking that ball away.
You can tell Kalamazoo's paying a lot of attention to Quillen inside. Hope's looking inside to him, and then Kalamazoo's bringing multiple bodies, similar to the way we saw Hope guard Jalen Overway in the Calvin game.
Yeah, it was such a huge difference in that Calvin game is Hope's defense, double, triple team, shutting down Overway. And it just got, they shut down the rest of Calvin in that too. So Hope's got to continue to go to Gabe regardless of the double team, and he's got to get the ball out quickly from his hand so that it can create the offense.
Here's Quillen. He's isolated on that left block. They like him in that spot. It was a good look for Hope. That's a good opportunity. Just couldn't knock it in.
Yeah, and looks like Tanner Wiggerink has subbed into the game. He was a revelation as well in that Calvin game. Just a phenomenal game on Wednesday.
Here comes Dykhouse. Ultra quick in the front court as Dykhouse got another great look. Just couldn't hit it.
Yeah, Marcus Warman checks into the game as well. The fabulous freshman coming in. So Hope seniors are out at this point except Evan Thomas and Clayton Dykhouse. And we're kind of looking more at our traditional lineup.
Kick out try, open look in the corner. That's Josh Decker, couldn't hit. Decker's a solid player for the Kalamazoo Hornets. Their leading scorer at 15 points per game.
And now Kalamazoo's gone a little bit cold, and Hope is looking to build off of that. The cold shooting by Kalamazoo, and that's going to be Evan Thomas called with lowering the shoulder on the charge call.
Yeah, Thomas thought about the triple, and you saw head coach Nick Giard, he was saying, sit on the drive, and then Thomas did lower that shoulder a little bit. It'll be an offensive foul.
Justin Mims checks into the game, another great freshman for Hope. Had a great game against Calvin, played really well, gave him some great minutes.
I love watching Justin Mims play defense. He's so active defensively, really quick, uses his hands well. Fun defender to watch for Hope.
Yeah, it's pretty incredible to have some freshmen like Marcus Warman, Justice Mims, that can give you a really great minutes. Great ball handlers, great kind of perimeter guards that can bring you good energy off the bench.
Impressive move there by Courtney, just couldn't get it to go. Dykhouse out to Warman. I think Hope's going to continue to attack inside here, looking into Quillen.
Yeah, they're swinging around the perimeter, continuing to look into that post.
Dykhouse step back triple on senior day. The seniors getting involved from beyond the arc.
Yeah, once Gabe Quillen has come into the game, it's really changed that because Kalamazoo's defense is looking to kind of put pressure down in Quillen, which has opened up the three-point shooting opportunities a little bit.
Nice back cut there. That's Olmeda. Unable to finish, and it's out to Josh Decker. Leading scorer for the Hornets at 15 a game. Nice job by Mims to poke it away, and just chaos created by this Hope defense right now.
Yeah, Justice Mims is just getting his hands, moving his feet, getting his hands in there, creating some havoc, and the turnover back to Hope.
Hope's going to get into their offensive set here. This is a nice lineup on the floor right now because Wiggerink is able to stretch the defense a little bit as a four-man. Quillen obviously dominant inside at times this year.
Really helpful at the Division III level when your bigs can step out, hit threes, be quick, and have good movement.
Oh, they were looking high-low in there, and oh, that one was saved right to Gabe Quillen. Can't believe he wasn't able to finish, but Wiggerink can!
The and-one.
Tanner Wiggering cleans up the mess, and he'll head to the free throw line to try to put Hope up 10. It's been a nice start for Hope, a little bit cold shooting early, but last few minutes they've really come on strong. Timeout. We're going to have a timeout here. It's going to be a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it right here. And, Matt, what are we seeing right now? I'm picturing in the Kalamazoo huddle, just wondering what head coach Nick Giard might be trying to say to the Hornets in terms of things to focus on here over the next couple minutes.
Yeah, I think Kalamazoo started out well on the defensive end. And once Wiggerink and Gabe Quillen came in, they've literally lost their shape a little bit on how to stop us. We have a little bit of a mismatch advantage with our height, and so Kalamazoo is going to be really going to have to be active, going to get into those double teams a little bit quicker, because if they're slow on that double teams, Hope's quick ball movement is going to create open shots. So he's trying to get them to play a little better defense and get those defensive rebounds.
Taking a look at the team statistics, Hope shooting 40% from the three right now, which is definitely above their season mark. And a big part of that is Brady Swinehart. Two early threes from the senior from Ionia, who was an excellent high school player, scored over 1,000 points in high school, played for his dad at Ionia High School for the Bulldogs, and two early threes. That has to feel great for Swinehart, who's really grinded through his 4 years here at Hope.
That's right. Tanner Wiggerink looks to complete the N1 and finishes with the free throw. We've got some Kalamazoo subs into the game. Caleb Call and Addison Atwater get some minutes here, and we'll see what they can bring to the table.
Speaking of seniors, Addison Atwater, the lone senior on this Kalamazoo roster. You said it. This is a young Hornets team that has a lot of the same players from last year on this year's squad, and they'll have some good continuity moving forward.
Yeah, Kalamazoo's in a little bit of a streak. They were up on Hope, and Hope has put together a little bit run at this point with their strong defense, and leads 15-5.
It has been all defense here from Hope. They have knocked in some threes, but back-to-back, really good defensive trips for the Fine Dutchman.
Yeah, the energy has just picked up a ton. It's nice to see our seniors start, and it's nice to see players come off the bench, honor them with playing so hard when they come in.
Warming over to Wiggerink. Here's Thomas. Thomas hasn't scored yet today. Mims. Oh, what an impressive play, hanging to finish. Justice Mims, the freshman.
Yeah, we look to see another sub down low with Ben Wager. Another big 6'7 player from Harbor Springs, Michigan, playing some strong defense on Kalamazoo.
Here's Horky. Oh, what a pass by Ty Horky, but it couldn't be finished. Broadsword had a point-blank opportunity. Nice pass by Horky. Here comes Thomas. Hope leads by 12 all of a sudden here at DeVos. Thomas so strong but couldn't finish. Got to his spot.
Yeah, Thomas kind of lulls you to sleep. He always plays under control, and he's great with his left hand.
We saw that in the Calvin game, multiple big left-handed finishes. Here's Thomas right at Atwater. What a defensive play by Atwater. Addison Atwater, the senior.
Phenomenal defensive strip. Oh, wow.
Ben Wager just checked into the game, takes a charge immediately.
Yeah, that was a really close call, but coaches are going to give him kudos for standing in and taking that hit right to the chest.
You see the replay there. You could peek Coach Mitchell in the background as Wager was going down. Mitchell in the background, hands raised. He knew that was going to be a charge.
I'm not sure there's much more that coaches like than a player willing to sacrifice their body for a charge. A beautiful backdoor pass by Evan Thomas with the left hand, but Justice is blocked at the hoop.
Yeah, a couple different guys involved there. That was Ty Horky. That was Caleb Call. Good opportunistic defense from Kalamazoo as Hope leads by 12 here, halfway through half number one.
We're looking to see another young player for Hope coming into the game with the Robert Nocek Jr. And he just brings a lot of rebounding and energy. He's been a catalyst, really, in some games with his minutes that he's gotten.
Had some big minutes in that Calvin game on Wednesday. Oh, Atwater. It's Hope senior day, but Kalamazoo's lone senior coming to play here with a steal and now a three.
Yeah, he says, I want to play in DeVos Fieldhouse, get some good steals, good shots, and playing with a lot of energy since he's been subbed into the game.
Thomas to Nocek. Hope leads by 9 here. Here's the ultra quick freshman Warman. Warman, oh, got his defender to hit the deck, and he pulls up and lights it.
That's one you might see on the postseason highlights mix as they say, break your ankles type of moment there.
Yeah, Warman's stop and start is really impressive. So shifty. Nice job by Broadsword to get right to his spot against Wagger, but Nocheck tips it away. 10 on the shot clock.
That's great defense from Ben Wagger. Just standing strong, not moving on that play.
Atwater, how about it? Atwater averages 4 points per game this season, already above that mark with 5 this afternoon.
Yeah, he's really brought a different level of intensity to the Kalamazoo team, and actually just some scoring as it's just down to a 9-point game.
Ben Wagger, no good, but Thomas creates the extra opportunity. Good unselfish play here from Hope. Mims caught himself in no man's land, and Rob Nocheck cleans up the mess.
Yeah, great rebound and then finish. That's what he does for this Hope College team.
Atwater, who's the hot hand for the Hornets, kicks out. That's Horky. He averages just around 10 points per game.
Yeah.
Horky, and now Kalamazoo kind of feeling it offensively. They cut the lead to 8 with a Horky 3.
The junior starter from Manchester, Michigan, with a great shot.
Here's Thomas. He's been quiet offensively here so far. That's vintage Thomas. Couldn't hit, but there's Ben Wagger. Mims is going to try a 3. Justice Mims. Another big 3 for Hope, and they're hot offensively right now. 5 threes so far in this one.
Yeah, Kalamazoo is definitely going to be talking about defensive rebounding, because when you give up a second chance shots, usually that leads to open 3-point shots. And so if they can get a one and done, it's going to be a lot better for them.
30-second timeout. We'll take a quick break and be right back here at DeVos Fieldhouse. Hope leads by 11 over Kalamazoo.
There is a school whose namesake is not a founder, not a historical figure, not a state, city, or physical landmark. It is named after an ideal, a virtue, a way of life. Its name is Hope.
Matt Margrone taking a look at some statistics here. Hope, 5 of 12 from the 3. That's just been a little bit different than what we've seen from this year. For the season, they shoot 31% from the 3. That's a welcome sight for Hope fans.
Oh, it's really good, and we're getting some good looks. Brady Swinehart, the senior, starting us off well with 2 early on in the game, and that's kind of continued on. Like we said, when we watch one go through, it kind of gets the whole team energized.
Here comes Kalamazoo. They need to put together a couple of nice offensive trips. Good ball movement here from the Hornets early. Leading scorer Josh Decker working on Dykehouse. Definitely has a size advantage there. Kick out Horky. Yeah. Evan Thomas is going to get tagged with the foul. Just a little over-aggressive there. Horky's going to head to the free throw line with a chance to score 3.
Yeah, and that closeout, you just got to stay down. When you go into the air, you're bound to get a foul on that corner 3.
I've liked Horky's game so far. Ty Horky, the junior from Manchester, Michigan, as we just said, he has started 15 games for the Hornets as that first shot goes in. Averages just around 10 points per game.
Yeah, the difference in this game right now, Hope's making some threes, and their offensive rebounding right now, 5-1. And so when you get more opportunities, more shots, that's going to create that little bit of an advantage.
Those offensive rebounds can have such a deflating effect to the opponent, right? You work really hard on defense for 20 seconds, and then you aren't rewarded with a defensive rebound. So it's been big for Hope as Horky knocks in the second, trying to get 3 the very, very old-fashioned way, and knocks all 3 in as Ty Horky.
That's right. And Coach Mitch is really looking to play 2 bigs at a time and use the size advantage for Hope.
Dykehouse got all the way to the basket, just couldn't knock it in. 6 minutes or so left here in half number 1. Hope leads by 8 as Atwater, who's had the hot hand for Kalamazoo, passes it off.
Yeah, Atwater has played really well since coming into the game.
Deep step back by Decker.
Whoa.
What an impressive shot by Josh Decker, leading scorer for the Hornets.
Yeah, and they've cut the game down to 5 points. 24-19 with just 6 minutes left to go.
Swinehart's back in there. Over to Schoonveld. Hope looks a little bit stagnant offensively on this trip. Swinehart guarded closely by Horky. 8 on the shot clock for Hope.
Clayton Dykhouse calls for the screen and roll. Kick to Eli Schoonveld for three.
Schoonveld just off on that triple, and another good defensive trip for Kalamazoo. Here comes Atwater. Oh, strong move. Nick Giard wanted a foul on that one.
Looked like he could have gotten one. Atwater drove it strong to the lane. It's really put pressure on the Hope defense since he's been in the game.
They're looking inside to Quillen hard. Coach Greg Mitchell yelling, get it to him. Haven't been able to get it into him much here in the first 15 minutes. Dykhouse thought about the triple over to Nocheck. Rob Nocheck off the dribble. Man, Rob Nocheck, not the typical play you see from him. And one opportunity for the junior.
Yeah, there was a little dust up. Gabe Quillen went down, took a couple guys with him, which created an open lane for Nocheck to go in. And looks like Kalamazoo's Atwater, who's played so well since being in the game, comes off a little gimpy.
Rob Nocheck, and you mentioned him, Matt. He's had some really big minutes and has taken a step forward this year as the junior, including that Calvin game, had a lot of just big rebounding plays. Not the kind of guy that's going to show up in the stat sheet all the time, but has been an impactful guy for Hope.
Yeah, I called the Albion game a couple weeks ago, and Hope came up just 1 point short, but he was really a catalyst in the second half of that game as well. And so he's earned his minutes for the Hope College Flying Dutchman.
Horky kicks it out to Bobby Samples. Now we're going inside. JJ Stevens working on Quillen. Quillen got a piece of that one. He wins that battle. Dykhouse to Mims. He's already made one. Oh, pinballed around up there and wasn't able to go. Decker on Nocheck. Now Nocheck is switched on to Horky. That's a mismatch for the Hornets. Another deep try. How about it, Josh Decker?
Yeah, Decker started a little slow in the game, but has picked it up with two threes in the last couple minutes. And Kalamazoo has cut the lead down to four, 26-22 with under the four-minute mark.
Decker's really come to play. That was with a hand in his face. Really solid player is Decker. Swinehart's going to try another triple. That one's off. Here comes Kalamazoo. This one's tight. Less than 4 minutes left in half number one.
Yeah, Hope pulled out to an early lead, but just Kalamazoo has gotten hot. So both teams had some cold streaks. Hope got hot for a little bit. Now Kalamazoo is closing the gap.
Yeah, a little miscommunication there, as it was originally going to be called Hope ball, and now the call was changed, went off a player's foot, so it'd be Kalamazoo ball on the baseline.
Yeah, let's keep our eye on Wiegerink and Quillen. When those two were in the first couple minutes earlier in the game, they really brought a great advantage for Hope's team.
Yeah, it's something about Hope spacing when the two of those guys are in, and baseline tries a nice look for Courtney. Here comes Warman. Warman, we haven't seen him be ultra aggressive here offensively here early.
Mims giving some good minutes to Hope at this point.
Mims on the left wing. Fallaway shot from Mims. And Quillen creating the extra opportunity, continuing the theme of offensive rebounding. Gabe Quillen too strong inside with the left hand.
Wow. See how he took his space to get in closer to the basket and get an easier shot. That was great footwork. You could tell that's something he's worked on from his freshman year to his sophomore season. It's been unbelievable.
Really under control, and multiple Hope guys hitting the deck, Dykhouse and Mims, as Decker lays it in, cuts the lead to four.
Yeah, Decker has really picked it up in the last 5 minutes, gained some confidence watching that first one go through the hoop.
Dykhouse finds himself on the baseline. Good ball movement here, though, from Hope. Looking inside to Quillen, it'll stay Hope ball. And Kalamazoo, you get the sense they're a little re-energized right now, especially defensively.
Yeah, Nick Giard, the coach, in his fourth season is really getting on him and saying, hey, give us that energy. We talked about earlier when Hope built that little bit of a lead, they were kind of slow on the defensive end, and that's really got them going.
McKenzie went right to that cup. Got to about 4 feet, but just couldn't get it to go. Here's Decker. Yeah, he's going to keep being aggressive. All thought it was going to go.
Oh, wow. He had hit two earlier from that spot, and he just kept going a couple feet back. That was kind of a Dame Lillard-esque kind of shot, but didn't go on that one.
Yeah, I think that's what we might call a heat check there.
It is a heat check, for sure.
Had the hot hand, and You know, you got to respect it at some point to take a shot like that. Gabe Quillen to Dykehouse, and now Quillen inside, and really good job of him to stop his momentum. Thought he might have gotten called for a charge, but he stopped his momentum, went straight up.
That's a great find by Clayton Dykehouse, the point guard. Little drop pass into Quillen. You got to get the right timing for your big man so he doesn't get called for the charge.
Good defensive trip here from Hope. Almeida inside to Broadsword. And here's Decker, go-to guy for the Hornets.
Kalamazoo is really trying to get those backdoor cuts, and Hope's playing good defense.
Good job by Warman to play strong defense. Hope finishes the trip, and they're going to go the other way, leading by six. Warman inside to Wiegerink. Nice move by Tanner. And thought about the right shoulder, goes over the left.
As we said, Quillen and Tanner really are the advantage, and when they've been in the game, they've expanded this lead.
Underrated find from Warman as well. He had his momentum really going to them, was able to find Tanner Wiegerink. 1 minute left in half number one here from DeVos Fieldhouse. Broadsword outside to Courtney. Another Decker triple, and that's a guy that Hope needs to find. He's at 11 points on the afternoon, double digits for Decker.
Yeah, he had zero in about the 10-minute mark, and he's had 11 just recently, and he's heating up.
Ten on the shot clock for Hope. McKenzie, now corner triple try for Dykehouse. And here comes Warman with the floater. Oh, nice soft touch from the freshman Warman.
As we talked about, Kalamazoo is in this game. That is a bad transition defensive play by Hope at the end of the half.
Yeah, Almeida got the easiest two he'll see all night. And now 6 seconds left on the game clock. Warman's going to have to go and attack.
It's a tough end of the half for Hope College with a bad turnover and a bad transition defense. See if Kalamazoo can capitalize.
Yeah, really just an awkward last 10 seconds of the half here for Hope. Decker, he's not going to get it off in time. Kalamazoo staff wants a foul.
They might have have some reason for that. Coach is going to go talk to the refs at half, but they can be proud of themselves for cutting this lead down to five. Decker heated up at the end of the half, and Hope goes into the locker room glad for their offensive rebounding, but probably a little bit disappointed in the way they ended.
Yeah, absolutely. I think Nick Giard has a point on that last one. There's a lot of contact. And first half, back and forth. Hope built up a little bit of a lead, and Kalamazoo battling back. I have a sense, Matt, that this is going to be a tight one right down to the end. We might have an exciting finish here at DeVos Fieldhouse. We'll take a break for halftime. Hope leads over the Kalamazoo Hornets 34-29.
Each one of these ladies has offered tribute to the rebirth of the Hope Panels cheer program and has set the example for future teammates. We are excited to celebrate with them today. First up is Jenna Currier. Jenna is escorted by her friend Alyssa Hurtka. She is majoring in chemistry and minoring in psychology. She plans to attend medical school after graduation. Jenna is one of the captains and a fantastic cheerleader and teammate. She is a very talented flyer and works well with everyone. She brings a lot of creativity to the team, and it's been a joy to have her. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Jenna Currier. Next is Jesse Rietsma. Jesse is escorted by her parents, Jeff and Becky Rietsma. Jesse is majoring in business and a double minor in French and leadership. After college, she plans on looking for a human resources consulting job with a large company and living on the East Coast. Jesse was also on the team back in the fall of 2019, and the team is so excited to have her back. She has strong technical cheerleading skills, making her a fantastic asset for this team. Her great sense of humor brings smiles and laughter to this team, and they all enjoyed having her. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Jesse Rietsma. Up next, Tia Hockenhall. Tia is escorted by her mother, Terry Hockenhall. Tia is a chemistry major and is also involved in theater. Her goal after graduation is to work in forensic investigation while pursuing an acting career. Tia has been a great addition to this team this semester. She has a great work ethic, has been flexible and ready to excel in any position she is placed in. She has a positive attitude and is an overall just a pleasure to have on this team. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Tia Hockenhall. And last but not least, Michaela Susser. Michaela is escorted by her sister, Aaliyah Susser. Michaela is majoring in communications with minors in business and leadership. After graduation, she plans on taking a gap year before hopefully moving to Chicago. Michaela has been such a joy to have on this team. Not only is she an extremely skilled cheerleader, but she brings great positive energy to this team. She radiates kindness and is always willing to help others. Everyone loved having Michaela on this team. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Michaela Susser. Ladies and gentlemen, one last round of applause for our seniors, Jenna Currier, Jesse Rietzma, Tia Hockenhall, and Michaela Susser.
My name's Emma Dutmers, and I'm a communications major, and then I'm minoring in environmental studies. I play soccer. The first soccer game of my junior year, I tore my ACL. Our athletic trainer, Annie, was there for me right when it happened, and she was there for me literally every step of the way. That was definitely a huge growing opportunity for me, and it was really hard, but it really pushed me to be a leader with more of my voice because I couldn't lead by example on the field. It definitely made me take a step back and realize how much there is to be grateful for.
As an invested community partner, LVZ is proud to share hope stories of transformational impact.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for your halftime entertainment, we have some very special guests. Please welcome your Dutchman dance team.
There are over 5,000 colleges and universities in the United States alone, and nearly every single one of them is named after a location or a historical figure. But along the shores of Lake Michigan, there is a school whose namesake is not a founder, not a historical figure, not a state, city, or physical landmark. It is named after an ideal, a virtue, a way of life. Its name is hope. It is so easy to get lost in what this world lacks, to become discouraged by its needs, gaps, and flaws. Can we see beyond the uncertainty and brokenness? At Hope College, we do. Not by ignoring the world as it is, but by learning and living with the belief that this is not the world as it should be, by driving to understand, to unlock clarity, to amplify truth, by leading with inspired compassion, by embodying a vision that illuminates greater opportunity for all, by serving with anchored conviction, using our collective gifts to offer this world what it needs most. Hope. Not simply hope as a desire, but hope as a way of being. Because hope has changed the way we see the world. And hope drives us to change the way the world is. Because hope shapes our calling. Because hope inspires our dreams. Because hope empowers our talents. Because hope frees us to try. Because hope transforms what we believe, transforms how we act, transforms who we are. At Hope College, we know this life-altering grace is a gift we have all been given, and it is the greatest gift we can offer the world. Hope transforms.
Fieldhouse. Tvet Van Wieren Court, the site of this MIAA matchup, the final MIAA regular season matchup of the 2022-23 season. Fine Dutchman taking on the Kalamazoo Hornets, and a back and forth kind of topsy-turvy, hard to describe first half, don't you think, Matt?
Yeah, you know, just both teams went through some shooting slumps, kind of got streaky a little bit. Hope built a little bit of a lead, and then Kalamazoo closed the gap, really with Decker shooting very hot at the end of the half.
Yeah, we were talking during the break, and I think Josh Decker was obviously the X factor for Kalamazoo, especially in the last 8 minutes or so of that half. The game was at a little bit of a turning point. Hope up 10 points or so, and you thought, oh, maybe this might get extended out to a 15-point lead. Maybe this is where the game gets broken open, and Decker was the guy that really stemmed that tide for Kalamazoo, and now we have a 5-point game that seems like it's going to go down to the wire here in the second half.
Yeah, you know, Hope will be happy leading the rebounding battle, 22-17, and 7 offensive boards to Kalamazoo's 1. They're leading the turnover battle, just giving up 5 turnovers to Kalamazoo's 8. But Kalamazoo's gotten to the free throw line a bit more, 4-for-5 to Hope's 1-for-2, and so Hope's going to want to get into the free throw line, draw some fouls.
Stat that jumps out to me is I think Hope's been at their best when their assist numbers are high, when they're sharing the ball well, when there's one extra pass to an open shooter or one extra pass inside. And Hope only 3 assists in that first half. So that ball movement needs to get turned up a notch. And we talked during the break as well about just the importance of looking inside to Gabe Quillen. And yes, Kalamazoo's paying a ton of attention to Gabe, but good things have happened when Gabe's gotten the ball in the paint.
100%. We got to continue to look for him. Gabe's got to be strong down there and receive the ball, get into good angles so he can get big, so he can receive that ball down low. But when him and Tanner are in there together, like you said, the spacing has been so good. So Hope has continued to use their big men to create better shooting.
Absolutely. Well, I'm excited for the second half of this one. This is a game that doesn't necessarily have MIAA tournament implications. Hope is slotted into that 3 seed. As we said at the top of the broadcast, they will host on Wednesday. Just depends who they will play, and that'll get all straightened out today. This is a Kalamazoo team that is young, that has 1 senior, that is really trying to continue to build positive momentum, not only heading into the end of this season, but heading into the offseason as well.
That's right. And, you know, if I'm Kalamazoo, I'm thinking I got a lot of confidence right now entering into the half, playing with a little more swagger, playing a little more energy. I think, you know, a huge part of that first half was Addison Atwater coming in and really keeping them kind of in the game when Hope was going on their run. He got a little bit injured, but when Atwater went out, Decker got going. And so Kalamazoo's going to be coming in and saying, hey, we got this game. We can win this game in the second half if we play the way we did those last 8 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the first 4 minutes or so are going to be really important, because this 5-point lead could get stretched out to 8, 10, 12. Or Kalamazoo comes out on a 5-0 or 6-0 run, and they can take the lead within the first couple of minutes here. So some big swings possible, and should be a really exciting second half from what's a really full DeVos Fieldhouse and an exciting atmosphere here in Holland.
Yeah, Hope is going to go with their traditional lineup, back with Wiegerink, Thomas, Schoonveld, Quillen, and Dykhouse.
We've talked, Matt, about how it just seems when Wiegerink and Quillen are out there together, good things tend to happen. Good spacing for the Flying Dutchman. It's good first trip by Kalamazoo. Nice pass inside there. That's 20 Broadsword that found himself on the left block. And we'll see if they say he was shooting. Oh, they will say he was shooting. Okay, he'll have 2 shots.
Yeah, it looked like he was almost in between a jump ball or a shooting foul, but it looks like Clayton got in there a little late.
Lucas Broadsword, 6'7 sophomore, as you said, from Boise, Idaho, one of the out-of-state recruits for Kalamazoo.
Super athletic kid. Just I've been very impressed with his length, his jumping ability. He's just all over the court.
Really valuable to have a player like this, a 6'7 athlete at the D3 level that can just kind of make plays. Broadsword's done that so far. He goes 1-of-2 for the free throw line. Hope needs to have a solid start here offensively. And here comes Clayton Dykhouse. Oh, they looked inside to Quillen. That was going to be their bread and butter, but it's turned over.
Yeah, we haven't talked about Bobby Samples much, but he's brought a lot of energy to this game on the defensive end. And now looking for the three. Wow. Just as we're talking, he cuts the lead to 1 point, and Hope's got to look to get some offense going.
Well, we talked about how the first couple minutes might be important, and here we go. It's two back-to-back tough offensive trips for Hope, and Kalamazoo's taking advantage. Horky pull-up triple. Oh, thought that was going to go for Ty Horky.
Hope clinging to a one-point lead right now.
Quillen thought about the top of the key three. Over to Thomas. Thomas held scoreless in that first half, the reigning MIAA MVP. Schoonveld stepped on the sideline, and three straight empty trips for the Flying Dutchman. That's not the way they wanted to start this second half.
Yeah, this is kind of indicative of the whole team throughout the year going through these cold spells and kind of getting out of offensive rhythm. And so they've got to have their seniors, Clayton and Evan, slow down the game and get us into good offensive possessions.
Here's Horky out front. Oh, nice play by Schoonveld. He was able to tip that one out of the hands of Decker. I think Decker might have knocked that in if he got the shot off.
Great defensive play, not letting Decker get his shot off because he was hot at the end of the first half.
Schoonveld is the right guy for that job. Inside of Tanner Wiggering now working on Decker. Decker reached in and looks like they'll get the second defender with the foul, and Tanner will head to the free throw line for two.
Great strong play by Tanner, causing the defender to get his hand caught in the cookie jar as he goes up, and Tanner draws the foul.
Love that shot that we just saw on the live stream. That is Paul Boersma in the crowd. I think I talked to Paul during the halftime break, actually, and Paul's on babysitting duty today. He's got some of the grandkids with him, so they were all swarming around in the concourse.
Paul Boersma, Hope College legend, and a local basketball refereeing legend as well. He is a Renaissance man.
Yeah, exactly. Does a little bit of everything. Kalamazoo basketball as Hope leads by three after the Wiggering free throws. Kick out attempt for Courtney. Good defense from Hope for his first 10 seconds of this trip. Here's Samples, who just made the triple. It looks like they're going to get Broadsword. Moving screen on Lucas Broadsword. Hope will go the other way.
Yeah, but you got to like Kalamazoo. The way they move the ball, they're quick. They're getting good shots usually on the offensive end. And I love Kalamazoo's energy to start the second half, closing the gap.
Definitely been impressed by Kalamazoo, just their approach, their mindset here so far. They've come to play, there's no doubt about that. Dykehouse left wing, nifty dribble move by Dykehouse. Here comes Thomas working on Horky. Love the defensive pressure from Horky, and they'll say that Horky reached in. Thomas just has a knack for that.
Yeah, Horky is looking for the offensive foul, but when Thomas gets around that corner just a little bit and gets, he draws people into that foul. It kind of has that little stutter step and gets the defender kind of caught.
I think you said it earlier. He just kind of lulls people to sleep a little bit out there and then is able to turn the corner. And then his first points of the basketball game for the senior, Evan Thomas, hits the pull-up jumper.
That's his spot at that little elbow. If he gets an open shot from there, that is most of the time going in.
Decker triple, that's gonna be good. Josh Decker, his 14th point of the ball game. What an excellent player is Josh Decker, the sophomore.
Yeah, Decker gets off that little screen and he's gonna make that most of the time.
Well, Thomas with the answer though. It's gonna be a Greg Mitchell timeout, and back and forth we go with some offensive fireworks here in the start of half number two.
Yeah, these teams are really living and dying by the three at this point.
Yeah, 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it right here for this one. And 5-point lead for Hope at the break, and still a 5-point lead, but some offensive plays by both teams being made as we see some replays here. These are from half number one, Gabe Quillen making his presence felt. Those bigs, we see a Wiggering highlight and a couple Quillen highlights. They're going to continue to be important for Hope.
It's good to see Evan Thomas get going a little bit here in the second half. As we said, he's the reigning MIAA MVP player of the year. He's missed 10 games this season, which is just tough to find any rhythm. And he is so important to this Hope College basketball team. Every other coach has the game plan for him, and so when he's out on the court, things just go easier usually.
Kalamazoo basketball on the baseline here. Horkey will trigger the inbound, and looks like Hope with a little bit of full court man-to-man pressure. Dykehouse is a good guy for that job. Yeah.
Samples calmly brings it up.
Good job by Samples to handle that pressure. That's difficult to do. Decker over to Broadsword. And Wigrant got a hand on it. They'll say that he got some body.
Yeah, Decker's running that little screen and roll game with Broadsword. That is a quick athletic cut to the basket. And Decker finds him with that little left-handed flip. And Broadsword draws another foul getting to the free throw line.
Broadsword no good on the first. This is a guy that has struggled from the free throw line this year, shooting 57%. So a guy that's gotten to the free throw line multiple times here today, but unable to convert on the first.
Yeah, young player, great energy, and just going to have to increase that shooting percentage from the free throw line to complete his game.
Dykehouse to Warman. Marcus Warman's just checked in to Gabe Quillen, and there's where Hope needs to get, right there. Gabe Quillen on the right block, and solid pass, solid finish. Hope leads by six.
Yeah, sometimes when you're just trying to get into that entry post feed, you got to look for different angles.
Oh, the long arm of Evan Thomas swats that one out of bounds. State Kalamazoo block.
Beautiful block with the left hand. But yeah, as I was saying, sometimes you got to work for different angles, go down to the baseline, corner post entry, because it just hasn't been working for him.
Decker almost got that one to go. I really like his game. That was such a quick release, really impressive by Decker, but it's Hope basketball. They lead by six. Warman almost turned the corner. Yeah, they're looking inside to Quillen once again, and a good job by Quillen to hunt down that 50-50 ball.
They're really looking for Quillen in the second half, trying to get the ball into him.
Once again, five on the shot clock. Good presence of mind by Quillen to kick it. Oh, and Dykehouse makes him pay.
Beautiful inside-outside game. Timeout by Kalamazoo, but when you, like you said, Jordan, when it goes in down to Quillen, good things happen.
No doubt about it. Hope extending that lead to eight now with about 4 minutes gone in the second half. We'll take a quick break. It's a full Kalamazoo timeout.
Yeah, my name is Travis Williams. I'm the CEO of the ODC Network. I graduated from Hope in 1998. I studied biology, and then I also played football. In order to be successful, people really need more than just the academic experience, but they need people to come alongside them and help them, coach them, mentor them. I find that Hope College has just been one of the best examples of being able to do that anywhere.
As an invested community partner, LVZ is proud to help share Hope's stories of transformational impact.
It's no secret. The best way to learn about Hope College is to spend time on our campus. The Hope admissions team invites you to a personalized visit experience you won't forget. Located in downtown Holland, Michigan, our historic campus is close to shopping and dining and just 10 minutes from Lake Michigan. We invite you to check out our campus tour options or sign up for an online tour with the Hope admissions office. There's never been a better time to see Hope College. Visit us at hope.edu/admissions.
Welcome back to DeVos Fieldhouse. Want to give a quick shout out to our broadcast crew here today, working hard multiple games and a doubleheader. Want to give a shout out to on the floor cameras. We have Valeria and we have Megan, who I think that's Megan Raisch. I think that's a Ranger, an FHC graduate on the camera there. Top cameras, Ian and Stryker, replay. Zach's on the replay. And of course, our director Channing and supervisor Steve, best in the business. Thank you everybody for working so hard and bringing the broadcast to those at home.
Yeah, unbelievable crew here at Hope College bringing this doubleheader today.
Ty Horkey, corner triple try. That one's off, but I love that offensive set from Kalamazoo. They're going to say touch Warman last, so it'll stay Kalamazoo ball. Got to give credit to Nick Giard there, drawing up a nice set.
Warman's not happy with that one, having a little conversation with the referee today, but it's going to be Kalamazoo's ball.
Here comes the ever dangerous Decker swinging it over to Horkey.
You got to love Kalamazoo, 5-19 team coming in here today, and what's probably going to be one of their last games of the season, playing with heart and energy that's just been phenomenal.
Horky shot that 14-foot really awkward floater, but then he's able to grab the offensive rebound. Decker and Warman, that's a fun matchup.
Yeah.
Horky.
Little play by Ty Horky.
Love the way he was able to turn the corner there, and then just got right to the backboard to finish. Thomas thought about the triple.
Hope just can't seem to pull away from Kalamazoo at this point. Kalamazoo hanging around in this game, and we'll see how long they can hang around, because if you let a team hang around long enough, they're very dangerous.
Thomas, I thought he was going to try to get all the way to the rim, and then he stops short and makes his second pull-up of the game. All of a sudden, Evan Thomas has 7 points after going scoreless in half number one.
Yeah, his mid-range game, when he gets that going, he just plays with a different level of confidence.
Miscommunication there by the Hornets, and all of a sudden, it's an 8-point lead for Hope. But this is another one of those turning points. And at every one of these turning points of the game, Kalamazoo has just stepped up. So big offensive trip for Hope here.
Yeah, you know who I've really been impressed with Samples today and his defensive energy. Kind of really shutting down Clayton Dykhouse at this point in the game. Clayton's trying to get going, trying to get other people involved. But Samples is playing with a lot of energy on the defensive end and then hitting some big shots on the offensive end.
Yeah, you see Samples, he's encouraging his teammates a ton, talking out there, trying to lead, stay positive, and got to give credit to the junior guard, Samples. Thomas, oh, tried the lefty move. And a nice defensive stand from the Hornets.
Yeah, great little play. Kept his pivot foot, but just left the shot short, which often happens when you're trying to get those little floaters in.
Samples swings it over to DJ Courtney. Nice, strong move by Courtney. What body control to finish off the glass.
You know, I'm really impressed with this Kalamazoo team today. Just a 6-point game with 13 minutes left. There is an energy and a fight. Call that a little bit of dog in them today that I've been really impressed with.
Zone here from the Hornets on this defensive trip. Hope tried a zone set, wasn't able to get it to go. Thomas tries from the outside. Oh, Evan Thomas, when he starts hitting threes, that really unlocks his game, and he has 10 points.
Yeah, Thomas kind of getting going like Decker did at the end of the first half. He started the second half, the first 7 minutes, and put 10 points up in the first 7 minutes of the second half.
Oh, what a cut by Horky, and a nice find by J.J. Stevens as well.
Horky's got a nice little touch around the rim for being a short guard. He can finish well.
Zone once again here from the Kalamazoo Hornets. And it stymied Hope a little bit on this possession. They look a little bit stagnant to the Flying Dutchman. Inside to Wiggerink. Warman fires the triple, and that's all iron. It's going to stay Hope basketball. And I think that the Kalamazoo, they got the shot they wanted. A deep Warman three late in the shot clock.
Yeah, I was just going to say the same thing. Like, Coach Nick Jarre draws up the zone defense and says, hey, we'll take those. We'll take you shooting the threes. I know your shooting percentages for the year. Maybe we can stay in the game that way.
Yeah, good bit of scouting and preparation there from Coach Yard. Thomas, who you can just sense is gaining some confidence as this game goes on. 10 on the shot clock for Hope.
Tells Wiggering to get out and then takes the three.
Justice Mims.
Yeah. Kazoo is going to be upset about the offensive rebounds because I don't know how many second chance points are in this game. Nice little backdoor cut again at Water with a great play and some good minutes here in the second half.
Seems like whenever Atwater checks in, good things happen for this Kalamazoo team. Thomas driving right to the middle, kick out. Mims 15-foot fall away. No good as we tick down less than 12 minutes left. Atwater with the ball. Again, we're right in that 6-7 point range. Hope's not been able to pull away. Here comes Warman. You get the sense that if Hope can extend this lead to double digits, this game would just have a different feel to it.
Yeah, Kalamazoo just hanging around, playing with a lot of energy.
Six on the shot clock, Wigerink inside and no check. Really nice pass, but no finish from no check. I like the offensive look though.
Yeah, they've been trying to go with that little high-low game where Wingerink gets the ball around the free throw line and feeds the big man.
Yeah, Courtney drove right past Rob Nocek there, finished with the right hand. Back to a 5-point lead, just where we were at halftime, Matt.
That's right. Coach Mitchell is going to want to shore up the defense, giving up too many easy buckets at this point in the game.
Get the sense that the momentum is a little bit on Kalamazoo's side here. It's going to be a full Hope timeout, so we'll take a quick break. Hope leads 52-47 over the Hornets.
Model, every student who comes through the doors of Hope College would have their tuition 100% covered.
Back here at DeVos Fieldhouse, and Matt Margrone, I'm going to feel like a little bit of a broken record, but this game has been back and forth, and no one has quite been able to get that factor of pulling away from the other group. We still have a 5-point ball game halfway through half number two.
Yeah, Hope's going to look to run the offense through Evan Thomas here in the second half as he's heated up a little bit and played more extended minutes. Kalamazoo is sticking with the zone, which has really slowed down kind of Hope's offense.
Oh, miscommunication there from Hope. And you can tell a little bit of confusion from the Flying Dutchman right now about the zone offense. They'll have 11 on the shot clock. Looking inside to Quillen, but Atwater's there to tip it away. Late shot clock situation, but a nice move by Mims and unable to finish. So quick is Justice Mims.
Yeah, he's got a great crossover into the basket. Gabe was trying to seal off that defender and just couldn't finish the and one. But Justice has given us some great minutes in this game. It's kind of a guy who's hard to keep off the court when he plays this way.
Yeah, especially defensively. That's the thing that you heard all fall about this freshman that was coming in. First thing that anyone ever said about Justice was he just really defends, really works hard on defense, really talks on defense. Those are guys that are pretty infectious and you want to have around.
That's the word I was just thinking of. That he's an infectious player that creates an energy that everyone feeds off of, and it's fun to watch. And I'm excited we're going to get to watch for the next 4 years.
Absolutely. Plays with some emotion, not afraid to smile out there on the court. Just fun guy to watch. He's D'ing up right now against DJ Courtney. Courtney with a nice move, and here comes Hope the other way. 7-point lead for the Flying Dutchman. Kalamazoo's back into that zone defense.
Oh, left him open.
Those are the kind of shots that when you go into a zone defense as a coach, you love when those don't go in and you really can't stand when they do. Almeida tried a quick triple.
Clayton Dykhouse coming up the court with his head on a swivel, just trying to run this offense against the zone. Hope really slowing down the game at this point in the 54-47. Kind of on again, off again game today, Jordan.
I think we're going to Garcia, deep triple from Dykehouse, no good, but Schoonveld, the exact right guy for tip-in tries as he really jumps up there around the rim and finishes.
He's got some hops, as they say. If you ever watch him in warm-ups, he can throw down.
Puts on a show. Here's Decker working on Quillen. Nice little Hakeem Olajuwon dream shake move there. Left hand and a really aggressive, nice play there from, that's J.J. Stevens.
Yeah, J.J. Stevens has given him some good minutes in the last couple minutes here. The freshman from Sturgis, Michigan, another young player for Kalamazoo with some good size.
I want to thank you all for tuning in today. It's been a fun day at DeVos Fieldhouse, senior day for the women's program, and they were able to secure a nice win over Kalamazoo and win a share of the MIAA title. And senior day now for the men's program. It's been a festive atmosphere here in DeVos, and I know we have people tuning in all the way from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to right here in Holland. So I really appreciate everyone tuning in to Matt and I today.
Yeah, one of the awesome things about being a part of the Hope College community is the large network that kind of expands around the country and the incredible fan base that is Hope College basketball.
Speaking of incredible, Decker's been incredible today. 17 points for the junior Decker. And once again, 6-point lead for Hope. They've never felt comfortable in this one. There's no chance that they have.
Decker is an unassuming player, but man, is he a good shooter, hot shooter.
Great pass from Wigerink outside to Justice Mims, and Mims making his presence known on the offensive end.
Yeah, Mims with the quick three answer to extend the lead back to 9, 59-50.
Decker deep triple, no good. And Justice Mims has 12 points here in this one. And like we said, known a little bit more as a defensive specialist. 12 points for Mims in this ballgame.
We saw that in the women's game today, too, that on senior day, our freshmen are showing up and saying, hey, don't forget about us. We got game.
Hope's going to be very content to use a lot of this shot clock here over the next few minutes. Up by 9, less than 8 minutes remaining.
Yeah.
Warman's going to try to get in on the act, and that one almost went. Here comes Samples.
I feel like there's 5 Bobby Samples out on the court today.
Samples tried the triple, and Kalamazoo's shooting has gone cold in the last few minutes when it's been very pivotal for them to convert on the offensive end.
Yeah, Hope's kind of clung to this 5-9 point lead over the last 20 minutes of this game, and see if they can pull away or if KZU can kind of get it in and tie it up or overcome that little mountain that they're under.
Dykehouse drives in again and almost gets it to go, but he'll head to the free throw line. And talking a little bit about Justice Mims, 12 points for Mims is his career high in a Hope uniform. So career day for Justice Mims, and he's going to stay out there for longer stretches right now.
Yeah, Justice Mims is a freshman guard, 6'2", from Rochester Hills, Michigan. Although at this point in the season, are you still a freshman? That's hard to say when you got a whole season under your belt at this point.
Yeah, that's what they often say, is that at this point, coaches expect you to play more like a sophomore than a freshman. You've played in some big games, especially playing at Hope when you play in front of 4,000 people at Calvin just a few days ago. You're pretty unfazed by this point of the season as a freshman.
Clayton Dykehouse knocks down 2 free throws, which is really big for Hope, to extend the lead to 11, which is close to our biggest one of the game.
Yeah, you definitely get the feeling that these trips are huge for Kalamazoo, and step-back try from Horky, and just when they need the big shot, Kalamazoo comes through. It's been how it's been all day for Kalamazoo.
All game hanging around, a little bit of a James Harden extra step-back. Could have called a travel, but the refs let it go, and they're hanging around.
Dykehouse went right inside to Wigerink, and see if this is on the floor or shooting. Yeah, they're going to say it was on the floor. Wigerink was trying to turn over his shoulder, and Honestly, maybe a smart foul there by Kalamazoo to stop the scoring try.
Yeah, Wiggering did the classic move where he'll just stand at the free throw line hoping he gets the free throws, but refs aren't falling for it. Going to keep it here on the ground.
Savvy veteran move from the junior Tanner Wiggering. Here's Warman. We've seen him get downhill today at times. Schoonville to Wiggering, and good charge shake there by Samples. Really a 50-50 call there. They go with the no call, and Hope leads by 10.
Yeah. Eli Schoonveld, not afraid to take the charge. Looks like him and Samples having some words coming into the timeout. But it's 10 points with 6:07 left to go.
Full timeout. We'll take a quick break here. Hope Kalamazoo at DeVos Fieldhouse.
My name's Emma Dutmers, and I'm a communications major, and then I'm minoring in environmental studies. I play soccer. The first soccer game of my junior year, I tore my ACL. Our athletic trainer, Annie, was there for me right when it happened, and she was there for me literally every step of the way. That was definitely a huge growing opportunity for me, and it was really hard, but it really pushed me to be a leader with more of my voice because I couldn't lead by example on the field. It definitely made me take a step back and realize how much there is to be grateful for.
As an invested community partner, LVZ is proud to share hope stories of transformational impact.
Back here at DeVos Fieldhouse, and Matt, we talked about women's basketball senior night, we talked about men's basketball senior night, but we have another senior celebration here going on at DeVos today.
Yeah, we saw the senior cheerleaders, and it's great to have our cheerleading team back here at DeVos. Last couple years, we haven't had our cheerleading team due to COVID, but it's been flourishing this season and been great to continue that environment at DeVos Fieldhouse.
Yeah, something about having them on there on the baseline just really elevates the experience and increase the excitement here in DeVos, and it's been a good day here in the field house for both these Hope squads. Nice pass inside, and bodies everywhere. Dykehouse comes out of the mess with it. He's going to push the pace. Over to Ben Wagger, and what a pass by Dykehouse.
Yeah, Dykehouse is happy about that one because that was a beautiful play. Defender came with him, and he dropped it off.
Such great awareness and vision, and all of a sudden it's a 12-point lead for Hope. Josh Decker has something to say about it, though, and here comes Dykehouse.
Last two times down the court, they are letting them play at this point. Bodies everywhere.
Really letting them play. Oh, Warman tracks it down. What a play by Marcus Warman. He was standing on the baseline, though. What a track meet here in the last 30 seconds. I feel like I need to catch my breath. Woo!
Wow. Both ends of the court, the refs almost said, hey, the things we've been calling all day, we're just going to let go for this next 45, 50 seconds. But at this point in the game, an MIAA matchup, you want the guys to win it on the court and it not be necessarily up to the refs.
Horky wide open, triple, and he'll knock it in and have the chance to go to the free throw line. Big play for Kalamazoo, potentially a momentum play for the Hornets.
Wow. Every time Hope gets to that 9, 10, 11-point lead, it feels like Kalamazoo hits a three-pointer to cut the lead back down.
Ty Horkey now finds himself with 13 points here this afternoon. That's over his season average of 10.
Yeah, Kalamazoo's got a good squad here. It's fun to watch them play. A lot of young players, a lot of athleticism. They play hard on the defensive end. They've got some shot makers, so great future here with Kalamazoo.
Unable to finish the four-point play as Horky. Hope now leads by 9. It's been right around there for quite a while here at DeVos. 5 minutes left in this one. Dykehouse up to Quill. Another really nice pass there from Dykehouse. They're going to get a shove on Kalamazoo.
Yeah, DJ Courtney got caught with that one, and that's going to put Hope into the bonus. Even though that's on the ground, Gabe Quillen will head to the line for the 1-1.
We were talking during the break, Matt, just about how impressed we are with a couple of Kalamazoo guys, but especially Bobby Samples. I'm not sure if Bobby Samples has subbed out of this one.
Yeah, you can see it all over him, the energy he's expended, but he is a great defender. He's a leader on this team. You can see plays hard every second, and there's a reason why Coach DR trusts him so much.
Quillen knocks them both in, sends that Hope lead to 11. Less than 5 minutes, you get the sense that this is a kind of a spot where Kalamazoo needs to put their foot on the gas in order to claw their way back into this one.
Yeah.
They'll say that Marcus Warman did not make contact with that one, and it'll be a Hope basketball. It's a costly turnover.
Yeah, in a game, again, like we said on senior day, Marcus Warman's defense has really turned the tide in this last couple minutes, and Justice Mims' offense. And so Hope's going to look to close out this game, and they're relying on some freshmen in some big moments.
Double high ball screens here. They're looking inside, and Quillen just got caught there, a little miscommunication, and be Kalamazoo basketball. Again, whenever they need a big play offensively or defensively, this Kalamazoo team's came to play.
Absolutely. You know, it's hard to not know what Hope's trying to do here in the second half. They're trying to go to Gabe and run the offense through him, and it's a smart move.
Courtney outside to Samples. Here's Horky. Horky going right at Quillen. What a great job by Gabe Quillen to stay straight up.
Great defensive play. Even though he left his feet, that's not a foul because he went straight up with his arms.
So tough to do. Really easier said than done. Good job by Quillen to earn Hope the offensive possession. Dykehouse, rainbow triple try.
Step back.
Greg Mitchell's body language tells you he didn't love that shot.
A lot of time left on the shot clock. Again, Warman with the little strip, brings it down in transition. Back to Thomas!
Thunder slam, Evan Thomas on senior day brings the house down off the pass from Warman.
Beautiful play at a crucial point in the game. Thomas, two-handed stuff. Hope he doesn't injure his shoulder.
He took his time up there hanging on the rim a little bit too. He wanted to enjoy it at Evan Thomas on senior day. Brings down the house. We'll take a quick break. Hope leads by 13 with 3.5 left here at DeVos Fieldhouse.
My name is Megan Bigelow, and during my time there, I was on the Hope women's soccer team. I decided to choose Hope because of the opportunity to be involved in multiple things. I didn't want to go somewhere where I was just a number in the field. I was able to double major, experience both a business academic load as well as economics. I love the opportunity to really get to know my professors. Hope exceeded my expectations.
I'm Nate Bauman. As an invested community partner, we're proud to help share Hope's stories of transformational impact.
The River Place in downtown Holland redefines active senior living. A no-step floor plan is designed around your needs, so you can leave the worries of home ownership behind and enjoy a vibrant lifestyle right outside your door. Make the River Place your home. Visit resthaven.org/riverplace to reserve yours today.
Moss Fieldhouse, the site of this final MIAA game in the regular season. And Matt, we were just talking at the break about how when Hope's able to get out in transition, they hit another level.
Yeah, phenomenal play when Hope can get those turnovers and Clayton Dykehouse, Marcus Warman can come in. And we just saw that with a two-handed flush from Evan Thomas. Just changes the whole energy in this place.
Left wing is Broadsword. Over to Samples. Kalamazoo needs to go offensively here with about 3 minutes left. This one is slowly slipping away from him on the offensive end. Horky tries the triple, no good. And Quillen clears it. Uh-oh, showtime. Oh, my goodness!
Wow.
Schoonveld!
Two in a row, two-handed dunks from Thomas and Schoonveld. Like we just talked about, when they get out in transition, it changes the whole energy in this place.
Whew. Showtime in DeVos Fieldhouse. Eli Schoonveld brings it down. Just as we were talking about transition, Matt, there they go.
Wow, you know, when he leapt from that angle, I didn't think he was going to dunk that ball, but he just kept going up.
We talked about it. Schoonveld in warm-ups shows that he can really sky in there in game time right there, bringing it down.
Yeah, and Hope has really just made this moment in this last 3 minutes and pulled away. Like we talked about, they've pulled away and created 15-point distance, and it looks like Coach Mitch is going to put the seniors back in the game.
Oh, what ball movement. Fun play right there. Schoonveld, Thomas, both getting a hand on it, and then the finish. Let's take a look at this replay here. It's a 30-second timeout.
30-second timeout.
First, we have the warm into Thomas pass. Two-hand jam, and then real pretty play there as well. Here goes Schoonveld.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
The in-air adjustment is so impressive here.
Wow, he kind of cocked that one back a little to the left and then still went in. Not many guys can do that. That's pretty impressive.
To go off of 1 foot like that and then able to adjust in midair and really slam it down. Schoonveld has shown glimpses of that throughout his whole Hope career. And especially last year, the game that comes to mind is at Calvin.
That's
on
right.
The baseline. He dunked on top of a couple Calvin defenders and pretty similar play there.
That's right. Looks like Kalamazoo's getting some seniors in at this point, and Hope is as well, back with their five seniors.
Trying a backdoor pass was Atwater.
Yeah.
Good job there by Broadsword to finish. Less than 2 minutes left here. All seniors in the ballgame for the Flying Dutchman.
Yeah, and this is a great time to just kind of honor those seniors in a 15-point game. Harris Hawkins, number 32, is giving high fives to Evan Thomas. Harris, a guy who came off two season-ending injuries to come play again his senior year, and phenomenal leader on this team emotionally, and just an incredible guy, business major here at Hope. He just represents all that Hope is about.
Yeah, talk about battling through adversity, and really multiple times Harris Hawkins proving just his toughness, leadership abilities. The guy at the free throw line, Clayton Dykehouse, has obviously played in so many big games for Hope. Knocks in a couple free throws. Evan Thomas, what else is there to say about the MIAA reigning MVP, who's just had an incredible career at Hope as well, as we tick down towards minute and a half. Brady Swinehart with the ball now. Saw him spark that Hope offense in the first half.
Yeah, Brady Swinehart, not a starter on this team, but a captain. And that just shows a lot about kind of who you are and your character. Harris Hawkins, love that. Gotta love that for the senior with the little step back.
Falling away, too. That's not an easy shot. Difficult shot from Hawkins on the baseline.
Yeah, and then TJ McKenzie, another senior on this team. Dual sport athlete here at Hope. Incredible all-league receiver for Hope on the football team, and then also a basketball player here.
Clock ticking down here. All five seniors on the floor for the Flying Dutchman. Going to be content to let this one run out. I think they're going to try to get Swinehart another triple try here. Three on the shot clock. Thomas trying to put an exclamation point on it. Can't do it. And they're going to intentionally foul to give these seniors a chance to get a round of applause as they're going to get Clayton Dykehouse. Ethan Crabtree checking in for Dykehouse. Zach Hawes checking in for TJ McKenzie.
Right. Sophomore and freshman coming into the game, but we're going to get all five of these seniors off. We got a standing ovation here in DeVos Fieldhouse for great careers by these seniors. Brought MIAA championship back to Hope College, which is huge in a tough MIAA.
Brady Swinehart getting a big hug from Greg Mitchell. Evan Thomas, the last senior to come off the floor, a guy who has cemented himself as one of the best players in Hope history, has provided a lot of great moments and memories for these Hope fans, and they're showing their appreciation.
He's going to be happy about that dunk here in the second half on senior day. He'll remember that his whole life.
Kalamazoo will be their last offensive possession here as we close out this one, and Decker travels
Decker leading Kalamazoo on the day with 17 points. Horky has 16. And number 20, Lucas Broadsword, has 11. So Kalamazoo with some great individual efforts, but just hung around, but not enough.
Hope younger guys on the floor right now, Crabtree, Leaper, Carson Sanders, all freshmen. Warman, a freshman, Hall is a sophomore out there, and give a round of applause. It's a W for Hope, and it's a senior day W for the Flying Dutchman as they close out the regular season with a win over the Kalamazoo Hornets, 77-62. And Matt, you get the sense this Hope team is not done yet. Not done yet one bit.
Yeah, you know, Hope, even though they've battled some struggles throughout the season, they've won 9 of 11 at this point. You can't discount them going into the MIAA tournament. They're going to host a game here on Wednesday, and after that, continue on this roll, and you never know what could happen in the MIAA.
Yeah, we've seen this Hope team for long stretches play well, and they played well for long stretches again today with a 77-62 win over the Hornets. Matt, any final thoughts just about the keys to this one and Hope with a 15-point victory?
Yeah, Hope ended up scoring 77 points. You're going to be happy with that after a lower scoring effort against Kelvin. When Hope's offense gets going, it changes the whole thing. And so I think it's a good day for Hope in that respect. Kalamazoo played very, very tough, very physical. They got some young guys that are really great. They're going to be tough to handle for a lot of years. But Hope just came away in the end with their experience and making a couple more big plays.
Well, you said it, Matt. Some big plays made by Hope. We see some on the replay there. None bigger than those two dunks in the second half. Hope wins this one on Senior Day. It's celebration mode here in DeVos Fieldhouse. Hope wins 77-62 over the Kalamazoo Hornets, and they'll head into the MIAA tournament on Wednesday as the 3 seed. For Matt Margrone, I'm Jordan George. It's been a pleasure here to call these ones from DeVos Fieldhouse. Two W's for the Flying Dutch and the Flying Dutchman today from the Fieldhouse. We'll see you next time, and as always, go Hope.